Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com. In today's video, I really want to walk you through understanding state, binding, object binding, and environment object in SwiftUI. If you want to save yourself some headache and build out this interface, then I highly advise you to keep on watching. So, hit that subscribe button, open up Xcode, and let's dive in. First things first, let's take a look at the demo project. What we are going to build out today. So here we have a tabbed view with three tabs, and on the first one we have this smiling emoji that is turned off. So that is when we don't code, and when we code we have this, I believe it's me there, isn't it? So on and off, and we are going to talk about state and binding in this part of the tutorial. Next up we are going to turn to observed objects. And we are going to add our points here. We are going to increment our score. And finally, we are going to take a look at environment object. I will talk deeper about environment objects, where we are going to type in our name. You will see why this matters at the end of this tutorial. So let's just jump right into it. And let me just close the demo tutorial. And let's take a look at our project here, SwiftUI State Binding. You can take a look at the project in the link down below in the description. Okay, first off, we have our scene delegate with a tabbed view. In the tabbed view, we have three tabs, content view, score view, and user settings view. Okay, this is self-explanatory. You can take a look at the project files in the GitHub repository. So let's jump right into our content view. Okay, here we have our switch view, and as you can see, it needs some more stuff here. But what you need to do is, let's have a text variation. Or let's see here, let's see if we want to add our sunglasses emoji. Okay, and hit Control Command and Space and select your favorite emoji here. And here we want to have an is switch view on or something like that. And we are going to use state, and you will see in just a moment why that is so important. So add state var and switch is on. Okay, and let it be a default value of false. Okay, now when we do have our switches on, we want to check if this variable is set to true or false. And that way we are going to set the text value. So that is pretty simple. Let's just use switch is on question mark. There you go. If the switch is on, then we are going to display the either of those two emojis. Now we want to add our switch is on state to our switch view, because if we just simply build and run now, basically we will see that this is set to false, and there is no switch involved, and we see that we have this with the sunglasses emoji. Okay, let's take a look at the switch view, and inside here let's create a toggle. So toggle, there we go. And inside the toggle, we are going to use this isOn with a label. Now, isOn needs a binding, so let's create that binding. And now we have come to the second part of our tutorial, the binding. So let's type in at binding, there we go, var switch is on, and let it be of type bool. Okay, bindings do not have a default value, and I will just copy this out and paste it in there. Now for the label, I am going to use a label or text label. So text, And before we move on to the text, let me just add in here a dollar sign because we are referencing this binding. Okay, now in the text, we are again going to check if the switch is on, and we are going to do that on the binding. Okay, now let's see here. Switch is on. Okay, question mark. If it is on, then let's type in on. And if it is off, then let's have the text as off. And that is pretty straightforward. That is all we have to do. Okay, and there's a missing parameter here. Let's just fix this for our preview. And for the binding, we are just going to add a constant of value false. This doesn't really matter. So let's build and run and see how all of this comes together. Okay, build failed. Let's see what's wrong here. Yeah, we want to add our state to our state variable to our switch use. So let's just start typing and use auto completion. Switch is on. Switch is on. Okay, hit command R and yeah, let's just fix this with a dollar sign. Hit command R to build and run. And now we should see everything in place. And I will just guide you through what is actually happening. Okay, yeah, let's just fix this real quick with the switch view. And let's just add, I believe it's fixed size for the toggle. Okay, there we go. And awesome. Switch is on, switch is off. Coding on, coding off. And maybe we should add a padding to that switch view too. So let's add in here a simple padding. Okay, so what is going on here? Well, basically this state variable is kind of an observable. It is capturing elements in time. So at a certain time, this could be false. At other times, this could be true. And it always has the latest of those elements. And as you can see, we are adding this switch is on. So we are checking if the switch is on and we are displaying the text. So this is checking. Now, how do we set it? Well, that is pretty simple. We are just going to use the toggles is on property and we are just going to move the true or false state up the switch is on variable. And that is why we need to use a binding, because we are in another view. So we are not in the content view, we are using a switch view. And of course, our switch view has this switch on binding that is added here. And we are importing, or rather yet, adding in our state. Okay, do you know that state is only available through your view, and this is how you can basically transport your state into other views with the binding. Okay, that is kind of it. I hope you kind of understand it. You really need to wrap your head around it. So let's move forward. Observed object. First of all, we want to create an observed object, and we are going to use that to count our score. Now, that is kind of hard to do if you don't use an observed object. So let's create an observable object class. So class, and let's name this user, and that is an observable object. Okay, now you could go two ways with this, and I will show you both. Let's just create the longest way, and then we are going to do it the quicker way. We are going to need a variable here, and that is scores. So first of all, let's create object will change object, and this is an object, observable object publisher, and I'm just going to add in here. I'm just going to initialize it like so. Now, because we do have this, we want to have a score. So, first of all, let's import SwiftUI SwiftUI, and let's import combine. Okay, the combine framework. And now let's create our score equals a default value of 0. And in the will set, we are just going to go self object will change dot send. There we go. And that is how we are just going to notify our score if it has been changed. Okay, now let's use this user stats. So under this, in the score view, we are just going to create a new variable, and that will be of type object, or observable object, or observed object. There we go. Var, and that is our, let's say, user stats. And let's initialize it by calling user stats. There we go. And now we have access to our user stats. So what we want to do here, and when we tap on the button, we want to increment the user stats by one. So that is pretty straightforward. Self user stats dot score equals one. Okay, so that will increment the score. Now we also want to show the current score, and that is also pretty straightforward. We are just going to use again self dot user stats dot score. Okay, how awesome is that? So let's build and run and see how all of this comes together. Okay, there we go. Let's go to the observed object tab and let's add some points. There we go, adding some points. So that is how powerful observed objects are. But what happens if this user stats wants to be accessed in another view? As you can see, I have initialized this in the score view, and basically I'm just using the user stats inside our own view. User stats here and user stats there. But what if I want to use, and let me just jump to the edit view, what if I want to edit our name? So because we are going to print out a name in a text field, what if I want to edit that name? So, and that is in a different view. So let's go to our user settings view, and as you can see here, I have a text that is my name and an edit view. Now we might just simply add in a bindable object, of course, in the edit view. But what if I want to use this all across the app? So that is where environment object comes into place. So let me just set up a little bit for environment object to work. First of all, we want to create another observable object, and that is simply called user settings, and it has a published var name, and this is the simple version of what we have added here in the user stats. So we could just simply use publish var score equals 0. Here we have published var name equals and an empty string. So we have already created our observable object. So we are just going to use this observable object as an environment object. And to do that, we need to insert it in the so-called root view that you want to use it in. So if that view has parent views, child views, then this environment object will be available for access. So now in the scene delegate, let's just create a variable for the user settings. So settings, user settings, okay? And let's initialize it. There we go. And now we want to add this to our tab view as an environment object. Okay, and settings, environment object set settings. There we go. And now this settings is universally available throughout the tabbed views, so-called subviews. So let's go into the user settings view and let's access these settings. So at environment object, there we go, var settings of type user settings. Okay, and you don't have to add any default value for this. Okay, and now in the text, we want to grab those settings. So settings dot and name. We want to add our name. And of course, we want to use this in the edit view too. So let's jump into another view. Pay attention, we are jumping into another view. And let's create our environment object again. I'm just going to copy this out and paste it in. Again, this is so awesome. We are in another view, but still accessing the user settings and the same user settings, of course. And here we want to create a text field. So let me just create our text field with a title. And the title should be, let's say, type in your name. And the binding is this setting. So all we have to do here is add our settings name, because that is the text we want to display here, and we want to push up to the settings name. So $settings.name, and we just add in here style. So I believe it's called text field style. There we go. And border, rounded border text field style. Okay, so let's take a look at what we have done here, and hopefully all of this will come together real nicely and with just a few lines of code, as you already saw. So let's go to the environment object. Let's type in our name, let's say Alex, and as you can see, it's already updating. And the cool part with environment object is that this text field is in a separate view than this text that says my name, Alex. Okay, now that is it for state and binding, observed object and environment object. Now, so far in this video, we talked about state and binding in SwiftUI, but what about tab view in SwiftUI? That's why I want you to hit the notification bell, because in my next video, I'm going to show you how to create a tab view in SwiftUI, the equivalent of UI tab by view controller in UIKit. So if you are interested, make sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss that video. In the meantime, make sure while you wait to take a look at these two videos that I have over here. I talk about SwiftUI, iOS development, and how to code smarter. So make sure to check out these videos as well. And as always, I will see you in the next one.